Hi, students. It's Mr. Heredia, and I want to go over with you today how to complete the Z-spread Gizmo assignment that has been given to you. So you will have your Google Doc, and then you will open up the Gizmo that is located on your student start page. So as I go down, I will click Gizmos here. It's the G with the blue background. You will be directed to log in with Clever. So once you get to Clever, you'll look for that icon again, the G with the blue background. So it'll log in and you'll have access to your classes, and then you can see what activities you've done. So I'm going to go to the disease spread activity. So I will open it and then I will pull up my Google Doc as well. So I do recommend a split screen or you going back and forth to read your instructions and writing down some notes if you need to. So here you'll make some predictions. And so this is very appropriate considering the time that we're in talking about an infectious disease known as coronavirus. So answer these questions, then do the warm up. So you'll just play what's on the gizmo and make some initial observations. After you make your initial observations, you'll then set it up for your experiment. So the first thing that we do is person-to-person transmission. So we'd set the number of people as we answers numbers, questions number 1 and 2 to 5. And so we'll make some predictions and identify what's happening. Okay. So the way we set that up is I'll make my gizmo full screen. So we'll go to controls. We'll want to set it to 5 people. We want person to person, so it will be on foodborne. So in order to change that, you'll turn it off by making sure it's unchecked. Then hit person to person. Leave the probability of transmission as it is for now. Go to simulation. Identify what the purple person, what they represent. And let's see how long it takes for 5 people to get sick in this situation. So again, you only get infected in this scenario if you have contact with a person. So when they touch, that's when they get the other person sick. So it's a waiting game. They have to touch to get sick when it's person to person. So I'll pause it. And so if you go to the table, it'll tell you exactly how long it takes for the people to get infected. So it took 63.5 hours for 5 people to get infected in this situation. So when you go to your question, that's what you type here, 63.5 hours. Again, your results will vary because it is a simulation. And so then what we're going to see is how that can vary dependent on the situation. So you have number of people, and then you're going to run each situation with that number of people 5 times. So you'll record your data. And so like I recommend to have this view up where you have the table. So I'll do one trial with 15 people, person to person. Let's see how long it takes for 5 people to get sick. So for this trial, it did not take long. It took 2.1 hours for 5 people to get sick. However, we're going to repeat this 4 more times. Your data will be different than another classmate's because your simulation is different. So let's see how long it'll take for 5 people to get sick. Now notice where our sick person is. Let's see how long it takes. So for this trial, it took 9.1 hours. So we had 2.1 and 9.1. So always hit reset. That way you start off with one sick person. So again, it's when these people actually touch or touch an object that they share. So it took for this trial 16.3 hours for five people to get sick. So this is the view that I would suggest. Select table. You start off with description, but select table. That way you can get the most accurate data. Okay? So that is how you will follow these steps to do your experiment. Then you'll interpret your data. Then move on to mess with the transmission probability. So you'll reset the number of people to 20 for that experiment. And then here, this is what you'll adjust. So person to person would be low here, person to person would be medium here, and person to person would be high here. So you want to make sure that you set those settings as such. So that's low, in the middle is medium, and high is all the way to the right. And so then you'd run your experiments, record your data every time in the chart, and then do your mean. Then you'll analyze. So here, place the probability of transmission slider under person to person, halfway between low and high. Select simulation and graph and play. And so then you'll do your analysis there. So if you were doing that part, you'd set your settings like so, have simulation and graph. Then you'd run your experiment. You can see the data points. So what do you notice for the graph? What pattern do you notice here of your data? And so that's what you would answer. Okay? And so then an epidemic is the rapid spread of an infectious disease. So think about how a government could prevent an epidemic. So this is something that, with the coronavirus was a big deal. It was called an epidemic or a pandemic because it was spreading quickly and public health officials were worried about its effect on us. Then for activity B, you would change that to foodborne. And then check your settings on your Google Doc. So the last setting we had with 20 people. So leave it at 20 for this activity B. So you make your prediction, then you do your observation to see what happens or what each person does before they get sick for that foodborne. So make sure that you turn person to person off as well. Then what does each person do that gets them sick? Okay, and then if you wanted to look at the data, remember you have a table, a bar chart, and a graph. Okay, so remember how this reads. Number of people infected are on the y-axis, and the x-axis is the time where it happened. Excuse me. So you use that to help you figure out what data you need and what how to answer the questions. Analyze. So here you'd wait for every person to become infected. So I would hit play to continue the simulation and wait for everyone to get sick. And it'll take a while. So I won't play it all for the purposes of this video, but you'll make your observations in the Google Doc. Do some comparison based on what you saw in activity A and make a prediction. So, you're predicting how airborne disease would be similar or different to foodborne disease or person to person. Then, when you get the last page, you'll do some with the airborne pathogen. So, you'll get some freedom to change how it occurs. All right. So, if I go to the Gizmo and go to airborne, I'm going to leave it at 20 for the purposes of this video. We'll see how fast the disease spreads. So it's already in the air. So it's taking a while to spread. Again, think about how it's spread. It's spread through air droplets. So airborne might take longer. It's all dependent on the situation. Because, for example, if you set it with a lot of people in the room, let's say my largest class would be 26 this year. Let's see if we had all 26 in person and we had a medium air-to-person transmission. You see, if people get into that infected air, it spreads quicker. But it does still take some time. But if it were a high probability of transmission airborne, and let's say we had a full room. My first year, I had a classroom of 37 people, 35 students, and two teachers. Let's see how long it'd take for us to get sick if we had a high probability of getting sick. So this is many hours of contact, but still within 24 hours, you can get about 12 people sick. And it'll take about, in this simulation, it'll take a couple days, but eventually everyone will be able to get sick. Again, they're sharing the same air. So that's why, in an example like right now, distance, some social distance, like so. Or if you're lucky, you'll have a classroom that looks like this. That's why it'll be so important. So I hope this is helpful and helps you review how to complete the assignment for today. Let me know if you have any questions and reach out to your teachers, students, if you have questions about how to complete your assignment today. Thank you.